was kind of surprised that there is actually a section on Twitch that's RE4 Otome Edition. I thought I had to keep the game as Resident Evil 4, but nope. Nope, there is a category for Otome Edition. I was like, oh, okay. But yeah, this you get to choose, you know, it's a dating sim. So you can date the merchant, you can date Lewis, you can date Leon. I still don't have the designs on the sweaters because I've been lazy. I need to go get either white lace or paint or something and just like draw the design on, like using a template or whatever. Yeah, with the glasses mod. No glasses, but obviously we're playing with the glasses mod. Any character that I do, I just call the glasses mod because I can't see shit without them. Who will I end up with? Oh, that's one of the villagers. What is this, Danganronpa? We got the pink blood up in here?
Resident Evil 4 Otome Edition.
Yeah, we literally got the Danganronpa blood up in here. Oh, there she is. Alright, new game.
Otome Edition.
Alright, what am I getting myself into? 200. I'll never forget it. Talk about near-death experience. Hey! Yo, Ashely, get out of there! It was the year everything changed. I became the president's daughter. And soon after, the target of a cult. Okay, so we got some music from RE4. Many years have passed since that horrendous incident. And in all the time, I never told anyone my side of the story. Yeah, see, so it's from her perspective. My name is Ashely Graham. And it's about time. No, I will not, gamer. I will not. Chapter 1. Holding on to a hero. Oh, that's cute! That's cute, the little chibi anime. Episode 1. Reliving the nightmare. Phew, exams are done. Thank goodness. Gah! I can't believe I made a C in government. I can just hear Daddy gripping about it. Think of the headlines. Ashely, the president's daughter, can barely pass college government course. Administration's credibility in doubt. It's not just hard, it's just supremely dull. Political theory is tedious, and it doesn't help that Dr. Div... Oh god, I'm gonna butcher this fucking name. Divois? I don't speak French, I'm sorry. Is a total mandroid. Where are all the young, passionate teachers? Ayo, high school, I had some pretty hot looking teachers, not gonna lie. My history teacher, I've said this story before, my history teacher was pretty fucking hot. Where are all the young, passionate teachers? That's what my generation needs. Dad is always pushing me to find a pet project. Well, I guess I'll have plenty of time to pitch in on my way back to DC. For now, better hurry and find my driver before Jenna finishes her exam. She's never more than a few minutes behind me, and I'm starting to think it's intentional. Yes, Ashely does not go to college in DC. She actually goes to college in Massachusetts, though we don't know what college, but at least it's in my home state. Hey. I pulled out my phone to call my driver, only to find that the battery died while I was taking my exam. Darn! I really need to remember to charge this thing more often. I don't need Daddy gripping at me about that too. Well, at least John is the predictable sort. He'll probably just be outside my residence hall. Started walking towards my sorority building and quickly spotted my driver's usual car. The person standing next to the car, however, was anything but expected. Krauser. Yeah, because Krauser's the one that kidnaps her. Ashely Graham side? What the hell? excuse me, sir, but, are you looking for me?
You're Ashely Graham?
Yes. Listen, if this is about my father's recent statement about slashing the veterans budget, I don't...
No, I'm your bodyguard. I've been sent by the president to escort you back home. Hey, what's up, Beasley?
Oh, Dad told me I would be getting a new bodyguard.
Caught you off guard, didn't I?
In the flesh. Caught you off guard, didn't I?
Ayo, Krauser are pretty sexy, not gonna lie. He is pretty sexy. Yeah, definitely. Although, did something change? Dad said I wouldn't meet my new bodyguard until I got back home.
Sus already. Yes.
Yes, what?
To have the plans change, we received initial intel suggesting that you might be a target for a kidnapping.
What? But we're in the hallowed halls of Harvard. Oh, so she's in Boston. Yo, let's fucking go. Hey.
Okay, so there we go. There we go, there you have it. We don't know exactly. Oh, yo, that scared the fuck out of me. We don't know exactly, but they don't want to take any chances. That's why I'm here. Heh heh.
What's with this dubious chuckle?
Probably just another dude who thinks muscles are a good replacement for tact. Been there, done them.
Well, Mr. Bodyguard, do you have a name to go by?
It's Klaus. Klaus? I'm pretty sure you can do better than that, Krauser.
Klaus, eh? Is it German or Austrian, maybe? You do remind me a little bit of Arnold Schwarzenegger with all the muscles and the scowl.
I was in the military. A few did call me the Terminator. Which, yes, Krauser originally did work for the government. Klauser. He did work for the government, with the whole Operation Javier shit in Darkseid Chronicles, but then the incident with his arm happened, and he had to be cut from, the government. So yeah, that's why he's jealous of Leon as well.
Yeah, I really don't want to know the context.
Hey, don't go anywhere.
Huh? Can't say that I could have pinned him as my dedicated recycler. It really doesn't pay a stereotype.
Anyway, are you ready to go?
Well, I was thinking of grabbing a few things from my dorm room.
We'll arrange for it to be brought to you. Don't know who you can trust out here.
Oh, come on. It'll only take a few minutes. Besides, my roommate...
Hey, Cole, what's up?
Hey, Ashely, wait up.
Oh, I looked to my right to see Jenna running towards us much faster than anyone could possibly think on a 6-inch heels. Good lord, I can't do that. I can't run in heels. Hell, I don't even like to wear heels.
What do you mean, by? Is it because I'm Ashely? Klaus, do you know what that sound is?
No.
It's the sound of bitch. I made an A in government, and I'm here to get gloat. What? I'm here to gloat. Oh my god. I can't be here for this. Act like we're in a hurry, Clow.
Some of us are, Ash.
I waved dismissively to Jenna as I approached the passenger door. Sorry, Jenna. I'm kind of in danger. I'll write to you on AIM. Who the hell uses AIM anymore?
Well, then again, when did Resident Evil 4 take place? 2004? Right? 2004, technically?
So, I don't know. I mean, at that point, I was on Windows. Windows MSN. Hey, Danny. Yeah, AIM was around. Okay. Yeah, at that point, I barely used AIM. I was more on MSN Messenger. Oh my god. Klaus and I leapt inside the car. It's a little neater than John usually keeps it, but it smells like his cologne. I guess Klaus doesn't get his own ride. It's the smallest cost of war on terror, that you don't think about. Finally. Oh, stop complaining and just go. Consider it done. Hey, that's what he says in the game. Klaus started up the car, which kept me hearing that Jenna was trying to say as she ran up to the door. I hate that I have to indulge her to just keep her from gossiping about me to the press. She doesn't even want me to talk. She just wants to compare bodyguards and grades. Well, Klaus, you're part of the Grammarly now. Grammarly? Oh, Jesus. So you should roll down the window and tell Jenna how important your mission is, and maybe she'll go away.
But, yeah. That's what it is.
Oh, he uses a flash grenade. Oh my god, Cloud, did you just blow- Oh, never mind, that wasn't a flash grenade- Oh, wait! No, that was a flash grenade, technically, because the sound effect was a flash grenade. It wasn't, like, the regular grenade, or the incendiary. Oh my god, Cloud, did you just blow Jenna up? Eh, it's just a okay, there we go. Just a flash grenade. Saw someone pop their head out of the bushes behind her.
Yeah, it's called the paparazzi, and they practically live in the bushes. Have you not worked with famous people before?
Just a bunch of flies looking for shit. Where's the harm in swatting a few?
Because those flies are people, Clow. People who can file lawsuits.
And with Jenna roped in, oh my god, she'll be feeding quotes to the tabloids for weeks. Relax, princess. Just trying to have fun. Besides, a couple of weeks from now, I doubt anybody's gonna care. Heh heh.
I'm glad you're so optimistic, but just humor me for more low-key fun from now on, okay? If anybody asks, we'll just fall back on the kidnapping threat you mentioned.
Heh, sounds like a plan. As Klaus drove away, I looked at Jenna as she stumbled around blindly groping at air. That should have concerned me more at the time, but pettiness is one hell of a drug. Okay, so he's reversing the car. Okay, what's up, Blessed? Episode 2. Take me on a joyride.
Wouldn't have taken Klaus for the Samba type.
I wonder if he's- Oh!
Oh my god!
Yo! Did I not just say that it doesn't pay to stereotype? I'm getting worried that hypocrisy is a hard code to the Graham family gene pool. Still, I wish he would say something. It's downright claustrophobic in here. Maybe he'd entertain for a few questions. But seriously, what do I say? So much fun are steroids? Yeah, there's gotta be something. Hey, Juan, it's a dating sim. It's an RE4 dating sim. I turned the music knob down a little, and Klaus' eyes darted towards me. Definitely should avoid the steroid question. Oh shit, here we go. Okay, so the questions are about my driver, about the scar, about your love life, about the steroids. Alright. What am I gonna ask? Ask about the steroids? Yeah, but she said that she doesn't want to ask about the steroids. Unless... Maybe we can ask about Krauser's love life? Because he doesn't have the scar on his face. But he definitely has a scar on his arm because of what happened in Darkside Chronicles. Ask about the... Oh my god. That's not a thing, though! Ask about the steroids. Are you I don't know, I want to ask about the love life. Okay, fine. Love life? That could be it. I mean, I want to ask about the love life, but I mean, if y'all want steroids, I mean, I could pick steroids, but me personally, I wanted to go for the... Okay, love life? Y'all want the love life? Because I kind of sort of want the love life. Fuck it, we're going with yeah, love life. So, you have any special someone back at home waiting for you? It's cool if you're single, too. Nothing wrong with that. I mean, I'm single. I thought maybe somebody, you know, you might have snatched someone up. I mean, a girl who can't resist silence and scars and muscles, right? Oh, no, I just made this awkward. I like men! Oh, shit. Alright. Okay, I mean, hey, nobody judging. Oh, yeah. I'm glad to know that we have that in common. It's important to have shared interests. Man, I so called that. Okay. Oh, okay, alright. Y'all wanted the steroids? We'll do the steroids. Am I stupid or something? That's the only thing that I'm gonna learn from the question is how much it hurts to get punched by a steroid arm. Oh lord, he knows that I'm thinking about the steroids. Enough chit chat, we're taking a detour. A detour? Where? Klaus swerved into the dirt road off the highway at a speed where he was going. It felt like my intestines had become a trampoline for my stomach. The path eventually leveled as we came into a clearing, allowing me to complain properly.
What's the big deal, Klaus? You're not Mad Max.
They want you back ASAP. I'm just doing my job.
Man, if he's this intense at doing his job, I feel so sorry for his boyfriends.
Alright, we're here. Let's go. Klaus brought the car to a screeching halt and motioned me to get out.
Where is here, exactly?
It's a helipad. We're gonna fly. You okay with that?
Not sure if you're gonna cope with an attitude.
This guy is something else. He's being all pissy with me, but it's not like I supported the bill for the veterans budget cuts and taking your aggression on Sweet Summer Child ain't right. Looking around, we seemed to be suspiciously on an empty and remote helipad, and I had a sinking feeling in my gut that something was amiss.
Hey, Klaus. Is this an official U.S. military helipad? I've been to a bunch, but this seems a little underfunded.
A little too quick for you. Catch on slow, as expected.
I'm not in the mood for your snark, Klaus. You're gonna tell me what's going on right now.
Now we're talking. You're being kidnapped, Ash. The rest isn't for you to worry about.
Oh, how could you do this to me? Do our mutual nicknames mean nothing to you?
It was fun while it lasted.
Is this about money? I mean, my dad can give you money. He's the fucking president, for crying out loud.
Sorry, girly. Well, I want access to Lord Sadler, and you're the payment.
Lord who? My god, what kind of political scandal am I getting wrapped up in this time?
Almost let it slip. Enough talk. Time to fly, princess. Okay, so that's how I get kidnapped. Alright. He uses a flash grenade on me. I have a mouth, but I can't scream.
I awoke disorientated.
Am I dreaming? I feel as heavy as I do when I've eaten a dozen Krispy Kremes. Not that I've ever done that yesterday.
I remember now. That bastard Klaus knocked me out. Did he tie me up? Why do I feel cold? I just feel so tired. But I gotta push past it. Come on, Ashely. Open your eyes. Oh no. Oh no, no, no. Oh my Christ, it's a Cenobite. What the fuck? Ah, a precious friend is awake. Surprising. Wait, no. I don't think he's a really... I just think he's a really ugly wizard. Not that he could be both. I mean, what was Pinhead but a wizard of pain? But more onto the point. Oh god, I don't want to be tortured.
Be at peace, Ashely. You are a guest of honor.
Guest of honor? In what, North Korea?
I hope you don't mind receiving gifts from an older gentleman, Ashely. It is a once-in-a-lifetime gift, after all. Unmatched in the world of freedom. Not your Hollywood version of freedom. No, true freedom. From burden, responsibility, indecision, you will never have to worry in your mind. The blissful ignorance of your youth will be everlasting.
What is this guy talking about? He's blathering about freedom, and I'm here strapped to what feels like a dentist chair. The irony might kill me before he does. Wait a second. Is that Lord Sadler man... the man Klaus mentioned? Why does he look like he came from a gothic Ren fair?
Oh my god.
And slightly more impatient. Why does it look like he's lived three times? Three lifetimes. Good lord.
Doesn't that sound wonderful? Free from the confusion of filth in this world. Living in an endless bliss. Is that not the very essence of heaven?
It is a parody, yeah. Wow, that's the exact argument my Sunday school teacher gave to me to encourage abstinence. Oh! It didn't work then, and it won't work now. Whoa, wait a second, so Ashley's not a virgin? I think she's saying she's not a virgin.
Your resistance is natural, for few people embrace change so readily, but you will see the light soon enough.
Oh, great. A real Aunt Lydia type. This will be easy to reason with. Stay calm, Ashely. Your kidnapping survival course prepared you for this exact scenario. I just need to apply its lessons wisely. First, knowledge is power. Second, courtesy is the password to safety. And third, if you look back, you'll soon be going that way. Wait. Those might just be fortune cookie sayings, but hey, point made, which is why I need to ask me some questions. All right, here we go. So, New World Order, are you a TV evangelist? Where am I? Oh my god. Fuck it, we'll go with the second one. Are you, oh my goodness. Are you Pat Robertson?
What's that? You'll have to forgive an old man in his hearing.
Jeez, I can barely get a word out, just like my early days on debate team. And I've learned anything from the debate team is not to dwell on a tough question. Next! As tired as I feel, I'm clearly basking in sedatives, so simple questions is probably for the best. I gotta push past the fatigue. Where am I?
Where are you? I suppose there's no harm in you knowing. You are in Spain, my dear. But don't worry. You won't be here for long. You will go quickly and quietly as you came.
Screw you. What? There's another person in the room?
Yes, Bartol. It seems that our precious guest would like your assistance in obtaining our power.
Lord Sadler, morir es vivir.
They named him Bartol.
Out of all the names, they could have gone with Roberto. They could have gone with Eduardo. They could have gone with Miguel. They could have gone with Castellano. Like, Barto? I don't know. El Barto. I don't know. I guess that's a name in Spanish Spain. I have no clue. But yeah, morir es vivir. God alive. It's like diet butterball. You move into my perifery? Thanks. At least I won't be visually traumatized. Now, my minion, remember to pull the needle in very slowly. We wouldn't want to hurt our new friend, after all. Yeah, I get injected. I felt a prick at the nape of my neck, followed by something shooting into my bloodstream. Something squirmy. I would have felt more revolted if I had the energy. Perfect penetration. Oh my god. Perfect penetration, Barto. You're really living up to your name. Oh my god.
Cerebro, cerebro, cerebro.
Morir es vivir. Yes, I will feed you after you finish sweeping up the room. Now go. I could feel my already tenacious consciousness beginning to fade, and I struggled to stay awake, but it was in vain. I was only comfort- The only comfort was the departure of those hideous men. I agree. As the eternal darkness swallowed me, I uttered a single prayer to whoever could hear them. Ashley's call was absorbed by the darkness. Oh. Father, I brought you Sarah as you asked. Good. Place him in the dresser and lock it tightly. Will the Lord punish him for what he stole from us, Father? That depends entirely on the good doctor and his cooperation. Whether or not he chooses to atone, we will regain what is ours. Father Mendez. Wait, Vitoris Mendez was a priest? I thought he was the village chief. Correct me if I'm wrong. I've been playing this game for years. This is the first time I've ever heard that he was a priest for the fucking village. Huh? Speak, my child. I need to Google that shit because I know him as the village chief, not no fucking priest. The American agent. He has been spotted outside the village. Then let us set our plan in motion. Has the president's daughter been secured? Yes, father. She's in the church. Good. We must keep the agent from reaching her. You, return to the village and instruct the others to deter him at all costs, but keep him alive if you can. As a precaution, take this file and leave it in the village. Somewhere, the American agent will likely find it. If you don't capture him first, it should guide him here. Then I will deal with him personally. Yes, father. Under your eye. Yeah, because one of his eyes are fake. Mendez wore many hats in the town, I guess. I guess he was a priest and he was the village chief. Consider your remaining time a gift, Sarah. Hopefully you will not squander this one. Ugh, what is this Satan's alarm clock? I covered my ears until the ringing stopped. The sound seemed like one of those old church bells they ring at European cathedrals. Apparently that's a romantic one from a distance. With the sound gone, I took inventory of my surroundings. Looks like some kind of dingy storage room. And considering the drumline competition now playing out of my skull, I assume that I'm in the storage room of a church. I got up and rustled the doorknob for formality's sake, but of course, it was locked tight. I'm really, really regretting taking construction as an elective instead of locksmithing. Seriously, when am I ever gonna drive a bulldozer? Oh, that's in reference to when she drives a bulldozer later on in the game. That's funny. I poked around the room for a bit, but it was barren. Nothing but barrels and sacks and hopelessness. Yes, it is foreshadowing. So kind of like a Motel 9, but even more with a urine smell. I slumped back against one of the barrels and gave my full weight and my attention to my predicament. So, I'm in Spain. I'm probably a poor part of Spain if this drabby room is anything to go by. Klaus was a trap, and an ugly old man, Sadler, me with something against my will as part of his new world order, and I'm famished. Are you there, God? It's me, Ashely. Could really use your help right now. Anything you got, just deposit it into my brain. I'll promise I'll pay you back. Huh? Oh, my tracking device. Yeah, it was in my scarf. Oh, God bless you, John, for hassling me every freaking day. Jesus. I drove down my hands to the fabric of my scarf. Oh, no. Oh, no. It's gone. God damn it. Ahem. Probably shouldn't think that in a church. Who gives a fuck? You're kidnapped! Who? What? At least that's what I would say if this wasn't the house of the devil. But seriously, who knows where I dropped it? Klaus could have found it, and we were in the helicopter, and he probably threw it out to sea. I'm just... So, it isn't... fair. And with that realization, the dam broke. For several minutes, I cried openly and cursed my terrible fate. My throat became coarse, and my gulping sobs quickly took one of a rusted gear. What? Blood? Oh God! What's going? Uh-oh. I awoke so suddenly, startled by weird sounds coming from outside. Not quite as hard as my ears, but the jury's out on what they'll do. What they'll mean for my health. My gut reaction was that it was just some of those cue balls going to whatever they pray for. Their master's love, Rogaine. I don't know. The movement is different, though. It's like something large creaking back and forth. Weird. Some kind of ritual, maybe? And by ritual, I obviously mean shunting. Sweet merciless God! I'm imagining it now. It's the worst thing. It was quiet for some time, and then I heard the screeching of a mechanism rising, and it drew nearer, closing in my makeshift prison. Oh God, they're coming for me. What if that Sadler want to do to me again? Make me the orgy queen? What the fuck? I don't know, because I don't listen to ugly old men, but it's probably that. Well, if they think that I'm going to be fertilized without a oh my God. Yo, this poor girl thinks that she's going to get... I feel bad for her. They're gonna learn a hard lesson in being sorely mistaken, Ashely. If this was the case, it's just you with a bunch of other dudes that will easily overpower you. I mean, there's... It sucks! But that's what would happen. I spotted a plank wood on the ground next to me, so it seems appropriate for this unholy space. Let's see how well it fits with in some eyeballs. Ashely!
No! Don't come!
Well, someone gathered the Dragon Balls and call me Yamcha, because I'm about to be What? Dude, this is probably the best line I've read thus far. Someone gather the Dragon Balls and call me Yamcha, because I'm about to be dead. Oh, it's great. Hey, take it easy. How dare him tell me to take it easy after what happened with Klaus? Ashely Graham is nobody's tool. Oh, sorry, fool. It's fool, not tool. No, get away. I persisted and ran back to the barrels. I wonder if he lose sight of me if I held the barrel between us at eyes level. Just because it sounds stupid doesn't mean it won't work. Calm down. Everything's gonna be just fine. Oh, hi, cutie. My name's Leon. I'm under the president's order to rescue you. I wish that I would have told Dad that I loved him more and that Mom is having an... The president's wife is having an affair? Oh, no. Politics, am I right? Wait. My father? My body surged forward out of relief. I'm saved. It's a Christmas miracle. My heartbeat began to slow a little, giving me a chance to examine my rescuer in full.
And I have to get you out of here. Now come with me.
Oh my. Oh yo, this better not be copyright music. This sounds like YouTube music. Doesn't it sound like YouTube music? I swear to God. Oh, I will go with you anywhere, cutie. Oh, that's me right now. That is so me. Doki doki. Doki doki. As my eyes feasted on the Adonis in front of me, my vision became inexplicably clouded by bubbles and sparkles. My brain also started playing a song that I think I heard in a laxative commercial one time. That is so weird, Ashely, but okay. You know the kind that says, if you just push hard enough, all your dreams will come true and your business will thrive. What the fuck? I've never heard... Okay, Ashely, you a freak. The point is, I'm saved, baby, by a super hot dude. Hooray! I had a million questions to ask him, but my tongue was dragging on the floor in the wake of his sexiness, so I just followed him instead. It's a simple jingle. I don't know, that sounded like YouTube music to me. Leon the Professional. As soon as I waked up, Leon pulled out what looked like an old walkie-talkie. Oh, he's holding the red 9 too. Wow, I haven't seen one of those in a while. I thought those lines were notoriously easy to jack. Oh, I know. He's using it because no one would expect a US agent to use such outdated tech. Genius!
It's Leon. I've succeeded in extricating my subject.
I love a man with big vocabulary. Swoon. He could extract me anytime. Oh my... Oh wait, I guess he already is. I wanted to make conversations since I hadn't spoken to anyone who wasn't Gross or Klaus for an indeterminate time. But he seemed... busy? Breaking barrels? I mean, Ashely, like, you gotta break the barrel, sweetheart. Like, that's where you get your ammo, that's where you get money, that's where you get herbs. What was the number, and what do, the words- why do the words Leon's Barrel Blast seem so predominant in my thoughts? Is this coping? Anyway, maybe he's making sure that there are no cultist spies hiding in the barrels? I actually wishes she was the barrel. I sure wouldn't want to be them right now. With every barrel decimated, I thought that he would at least ask about my general state of health, but instead he moved briskly towards the door. Is he the Kudere type? Really, we're going there? We're going tsundere, kundere, kudere, yandere? We're really going with that? Oh my god. Those are always a bummer in a crisis, especially emotional ones. Whoa, this testosterone is palpable. Hey, gotta assert his dominance, you know? T-pose. But hey, any dude can open a door for a lady. It takes a real gentleman to open him in a way that reflects how badly she wants to exit said door. We ran down the snaking corridor and approached the ladder. Did anyone carry me up this thing? Seems pretty crazy, but par for the course, I guess. Before I could even look over the ledge, Leon jumped down to the ground, landing with a confident thud. Now there's a man who doesn't waste any time. Well, when you're in Spain... Oh, jeez. I know I could get a little dizzy around cute boys, but that was unnecessarily impulsive, kind of. I couldn't even control myself. So what she's saying is, Leon is so fucking hot and I wanted to, like, get up in there that I went all swoon and I couldn't think and I accidentally fell so that way he could catch me in his arms bridal style. I think that's what she's going on here. In any case, I should probably get out of his arms, so it doesn't seem like I'm enjoying it as much as I am. Facts. Logic checks. It literally! Like, it makes perfect sense. Like, you know, she went all swoon. She wants to be in Leon's arms, and yeah, she's like, oh my god, let me fake fall so that he can capture me. Bridal style. Oh man, how great would it be if it was just a platoon of equally hot Secret Service guys waiting outside the church, ready to escort me out of this nightmare? My reverse harem story begins now! Oh my god, she's really going there, yo! Reverse harem. Before we could even reach the door, a familiar voice chimed in behind us. That voice! That kind of huskiness of an old pervert if I ever heard one! Who the heck are you? Well, if you must know, my name is Osman Sadler, the master of this fine religious community. Did he seriously just refer to him as Awesome Saddle? He might as well wear one on- wear a sign on his face that says, proud to be a celibate. Then he'd be doing the world two favors. It's Adam Sandler. You go, what do you want? I knew I would hate this guy's face in high definition. Looks like I'm becoming, it feels like I'm becoming an atheist, retroactively just by looking at him. To demonstrate the whole world of our astounding power, of course. No longer will the United States think that they could police the world forever. So we kidnapped the president's daughter in order to give her our power and then send her back. No. Suddenly and regrettably, I wash, in a wash of memories of my injection, so that's why they wanted me. In short, I'm an unwilling female's ruler in a men's- Whoa, what? The unwilling female ruler in a men's dick measuring contest, tale as old as time. That's scary. Well, in the spirit of saying, the quiet part loud, I guess I should add some context. Well, this is horror, true. We planted her a little gift, and there's gonna be one hell of a loving father. I thought I might bargain for quite a lot of money to keep this church up and running. Adamantly, I was fearing over the protective growl in Leon's, in Leon's voice, and didn't really pay a lot of attention to the last part. Something about gifting some plants to my dad in exchange for donations? Well, joke's on you, pal. My dad hates charities and the environment. Faith in money will lead you nowhere, Sadler. Yeah, that's right, Leon. You stick it to the prosperity gospel. I know I said that wrong. I said that so wrong. I believe I forgot to tell you that we gave you the same gift. When I was unconscious? My god, he looks fine from this angle. Hey, yo, that'd be me too. Oh, wait, what? Same gift? Oh, Leon, no. We'll bond over this, I promise. Special contributions, my puppets. You'll do as I say, and I'll have total control. Revolutionary. God, this whole evil dude recites evil plans thing is wicked boring. So, someone really needs to awaken him from his world of cliches. I like that. Because that's what Sadler says to Leon. Yo, Hollywood movies, blah, blah, blah. It happens in cliches. Maybe Leon should do it with a bullet. Sounds more like an alien invasion, if you ask me. Robo bullets are not bullets, Leon. Suddenly, we were blocked by the exit by more of those diet butterballs. Maybe Leon's onto something here. Not gonna lie, confident smirks of what now, bitch? Variety undeniably. Wait, but actually, you called this man an old fucking pervert and blah blah blah, religious cultist and shit, and now you say that he's sexy? Which one is it? Too bad it's on the face that has all the dating potential of garbage bag. True. Ooh la la, Leon, you think what I'm thinking? Drop these fools in a dramatic western shootout? Or we could run away, that's cool too, and maybe even save. Whoa, that was way too close. Freaking crossbow nerds, is there any insufferable enemy type? Leon pulled me to the end of the corridor, but all I could see was a glass window. Maybe he doesn't know. Before I could even vocalize my surprise, we crashed through the window, and quite easily, I might add. Very true. Very, very true. Maybe these church windows are, kind of weak. It's a weird, subtle display of wealth in importing sugar windows from Hollywood rather than supporting the local glass economy. For all of his beef with America, Sadler must like our movies. We certainly would explain why he hired Klaus. It was very dangerous and stupid, but what cool stuff isn't? True. I landed about as well as Dad's first TV debate, but to be fair, I was prepared for a diehard escape shenanigans. Even the supreme gentleman, Leon, jumped to my aid in a flash. Physically? Still a one piece. Psychologically? Crumbling. I agree. Still, I don't want to lie to him, so I just evaded the question like I do at all my political interviews. Leon, what's gonna happen to us? I knew it was a pointless question, but I felt like I was entitled to a little neediness. Besides, guys like that stuff, or so I've read in Cosmo. You got into this mess? We can get out. I like how he says we, as if we aren't. If this weren't 100% my fault, but hey, if he's okay with cutting me some slack, who am I to disagree? My heart swelled as Leon took a hold of my arm and grasped both tender and protective. In truth, universally acknowledged that a single woman in so much danger must be in want of a bodyguard, and oh boy, did I get one. Ayo, sign me up. Shit. I don't want to be buried in a cult cemetery. Interesting. Once we were both up, I huddled close to Leon, looking around. It seemed like we had landed in some external storage. There was a little room aside from some bags and barrels, so I didn't imagine that we'd loiter long. But Leon had other plans. Look, he's gonna go for the barrels. Yup. I think this is some kind of hobby of his. Or maybe barrels killed his parents and now he's sworn to destroy all kinds of barrels. Leon nabbed Spanish gold. Oh, I hadn't noticed this before, but while I was salivating over Leon, there's some good stuff in these barrels. Ammo, gold, some kind of plant material? You know, resources. Leon grabbed the goods and shoved them into his pockets. I guess that explains his obsessive interest in barrels. But who keeps that kind of stuff in barrels in such sparse quantities? Is it some kind of rural geo-coaching? Looking for bullets and pocket change down at the local church? Spain is weird. You know what's also weird? That we're not being shot full of arrows. I look back at the window that saddle I thought that said saddle titties for a second. satellites had more than enough time to follow us. We were only a few feet down and would make for pathetically easy targets, and yet, nada. Does their cult Bible prohibit them from exploiting obvious advantages? No, she does have a point. She does have a point. Are they having a synergy meeting? Are they sad about their broken splendos? I shrugged my questions aside, knowing that there were no answers, and if there were, then they're probably not worth knowing. I love how there's a barrel counter. I looked up at Leon, who finally seemed satisfied that he fully raided the church provisions, and we hustled over to the door and made our way outside. As we ran to the front of the church building, rain whipping anonymously around us, we encountered what looks like an angry mob of villagers. They were just groaning at first, and then they ambled slowly toward the church. Then a few of them started to shout.
Un forastero!
Ahí está!
Excuse me.
Ahí está! No dejes que se escape!
Here's another regret for the pile. Zoning in high school Spanish. So she failed high school Spanish. Something about not letting the forest hero escape? She thought forestero is forest. I give you credit for trying, Ashely. You got the escape part right, but forest? No. Foreign languages is hard. It is hard, especially when you're learning a new language as an adult. We slowly inched our way down the path, presumably to see how they would react. I have hope that it might just be hard to fight for the man that's raising taxes and stealing their chickens. But lunging them towards us with death in their eyes squashed the idea pretty fast. Leon coolly stood his ground, gun drawn, and I had thought that he could shoot the wagon in front of us, and maybe that would, I don't know, distract them from something? Seemed like a long shot. Leave it to Leon, shoot him. Yo, shoot him! Pew, pew, pew! Well, here's hoping that this isn't the dumbest idea I've ever had.
Leon, shoot those barrels on that wagon!
And without a wood, Leon without a wood, Jesus Christ, without a word, Leon took aim at the barrels. Admittedly, I don't know if he trusted my judgment on this or wanted another opportunity to destroy barrels. But to my great satisfaction, the barrels spontaneously combusted, causing the wagon to roll towards the villagers like some kind of blazing poverty chariot. I really don't understand why a church would have explosive barrels on hand. Maybe that was their wine? Is wine flammable? Live hard, drink harder, I guess. Oh, I get it. That must have been the communion cart filled with the blood of Christ, which erupts into the flames of Perdition? I don't know. Feels like someone is confusing their testaments. Oh my god. Let's see. Nonetheless, the Spanish flea song in my head, all of a sudden— oh, whoa, okay. With the villagers, crushed and or combusted by their own flaming, paddy wagon, we took the opportunity to run past. Between the oppressive, darkness and driving rain, I could see the path, but Leon seemed to know where he's going, so I just followed closely. A bolt of light tore across the sky, and I realized that I was looking at a graveyard. That's not ominous at all. Nuh-uh. One might say it's sacrilege to kill the faith in such a hallowed place, but even greater sacrilege to think, well, at least you won't have to drag the bodies far. Having escaped the crazed villagers, we jogged leisurely down a narrow forest path until it abruptly ended at a ladder. In a standard horror movie fashion, going fast forward meant going down. The ladder took us down a dark cavern, notably devoid of trigger warnings for claustrophobia, or worse, cave crickets. We moved briskly down the path, and soon found ourselves in front of a rusty door. Leon began to push open the door with tenderness of a kitten. I'm not sure if I should be charmed by his newfound discretion or alarmed by his sudden caution. What in the blue blazes?! I was immediately entrapped by the warmth of circling in the cavern. It felt safe, cozy even. If I had a glass bottle, I could take some of the feeling with me, and maybe melt ice around Leon's demeanor. Melt the ice around his— oh my god. Fucking Ashely. It was perhaps the soothing nature of the flames that kept me from screaming when I saw the figure stationed between them. Whoa, who's the man in black? Another secret agent? Or just your run-of-the-mill small-town gun nut going through a man cave phase? Yo, she's actually romanticizing the whoa! Why am I seeing bubbles and sparkles again? How hard up am I? What the fuck? Alright, this? Whoa, why is my eye moving this way? Is the parasite giving me superpowers? I feel like I could sneak in a lot more, gawking before it got awkward. My, what a big sack he has, teehee. Oh my god! His hand's a little dirty, but it adds convincingly to the forest hobo aesthetic that he's going. Where does he even get a coat like this? A suspicious person thrift shop? Is that a skirt? I'm not judging. I'm appreciating. Okay. Bandana. I dig the bandana. It says I don't sacrifice fashion just to obscure my identity. It also looks pretty warm, much unlike myself right now. Yo, facts. I feel bad for this poor girl getting kidnapped in the outfit that she's in. Hey, Asgar, how are ya? Assessment. Well, he seems, well-stoked, both in terms of munitions and mystery, but not attractive enough to be out of my league. I'm liking my odds. So yes, you can get into a relationship with the merchant. Leon approached the man casually, so I assumed that they're working together in some capacity. The more the merrier, I guess. But he's not as clean-looking as Leon, but he may be better armed. A girl in peril has to keep her options open.
Welcome. got a selection of good things on sale, stranger.
Stranger! Huh? Not the accent I was expecting, but in a good way, Australian maybe? I'm all about the down under, but I think it was just that. While I questioned my moral credibility, Leon started browsing the man's inventory.
What are you buying? Thank you.
No, definitely not Australian.
Is that all, stranger? What are you selling?
The merchant quitted enthusiastically as Leon stoically pursued his wares. Maybe it's part of the Leon safety protocols to avoid conversation where possible?
I'll buy it at a high price.
The merchant seemed to be pretty excited about some jewels that Leon showed him. Whoa, is that the bejeweled beer stain? Am I observing the black market in real time? I can't believe they're making Leon break barrels and pilfer valuables just to obtain supplies. Either my rescuer is on a low-budget affair, or our foreign policy is woefully inadequate.
Come back any time.
As Leon finished shopping, I thought I should wave to the merchant man, but I didn't want to mistakenly initiate another romance just yet. I wonder what that was for. Testing for water traps, maybe? Still seems a little rude to just vandalize the merchant's place of business. Whatever the reason, Leon swept past the flame like a man on a mission. By which I mean he hurried over to the box tuckered in the nook. As if by instinct, he drew his knife, cause what if the box was not a barrel disguised as a rectangle? Ah, crates really do have its uses, so we got ammo. We ran through the remaining tunnel and climbed some stairs to another ladder leading upwards. Ashely is spitting facts. As I ascended, I heard the telltale sound of wood being victimized. Once at the top, I huddled close to Leon again as he approached through the door to the next room. Despite all of Leon's caution, the room was pretty barren, save for a bizarrely large typewriter on the table, or maybe regular sized, I don't even know, I wasn't born in the 50s. Maybe someone's writing a novel? I guess I should be a writer too, if it got me out of Blighttown? Better Frame Rate Edition? Okay, I don't know that reference to be honest. Leon suddenly started typing away with the same dutiful air of a person filing their taxes. Perhaps he was hemorrhaging aspirations would explain the tierness.